Witta ngappa kiri kiri watalabana. Manga men, manga lady, the significance of, you know, them two finds, very important to our people, not only our people, but also the broader, you know, Aboriginal people in Australia. You know, they come to surface for a reason, to let people know that we've been here for 40,000 years plus.
And they have informed us about the culture, the ritual, the ceremony associated with those burials, and they give us a depth of appreciation of the landscape, the culture and the heritage that we have here in Australia.
He was not only buried 42,000 years ago, 42,000 years ago on the edge of the lake, but buried with extraordinary ritual. That ritual burial, which involved the digging of the grave, there was a fire very close by. His community had gathered ochre. There's no ochre within 100 kilometres of this site. The ochre was brought in. The ochre we found had been either painted on the body or sprinkled on the grave.
They're important people of our tribe, of, you know, the Aboriginal custodians of this area. Simple reasons why. Mungo man, you know, he was painted in ochre, and he was buried in a crouch burial, where Mungo lady, she was, you know, she was a cremated burial, and she, you know, so they took time to actually prep them for, you know, ceremony.
See, the scientific evidence is one thing. The scientific evidence was there. We know the age of the burial, we know that he was anointed or painted with ochre, but behind that, the meaning of that act is extraordinary. It is one in which these people were identifying their connection with the land, connection with country. Aboriginal people have it today. That act of bringing the ochre from the earth onto the body, that was a conscious act of reconnecting between people and country, between people and nature.